So guys, over here we are going to use this Heltec ESP32 based LoRa module, and this does come with one OLED display on board. And along with that, we have got this LiPo battery connector. So if you want to run it using battery, you can do so. So the OLED display over here is just the I2C bus, whereas the LoRa module or the LoRa chip present on board uses the SPI port. So you can see with this, actually I have got the pin diagram of the module itself, and you will see there are pins which are marked in red arrows, and those are the pins being used by the onboard peripherals like the OLED display as well as the LoRa module. As the OLED display takes up the I2C bus and the LoRa module takes up the SPI bus. So whenever you are connecting external peripherals, just keep in mind the SPI and I2C bus are already being used by the onboard peripherals. So connect your devices accordingly. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the pin number 12 and 13, the DPIO 12 and 13, to connect this push button over here along with one LED. So what will happen is I'll just connect it, and whenever I'll push the button, it will send a message to the TTN cloud. And if the message has been delivered successfully, the LED will blink twice. And if I have like scheduled a downlink and it has received a message from TTN cloud, it will simply blink the LED thrice. So along with this board and the buttons and all, I have got this LoRa antenna over here that is for 868 MHz, because the module is I'm having for 868 MHz, because my gateway supports, or over here in my country, it is 865 to 867 MHz that can be used with LoRa. So before powering off, just don't forget to connect the LoRa antenna, because if you are not connecting the antenna, it may fry your board. So I'll just quickly connect and we'll get back to code and see how to do it. So guys, after the hardware is set off and is connected to the PC, let's open up Arduino. And over here, we need to install a couple of libraries to support the OLED module as well as the LoRa module. But before that, just make sure you have installed the ESP32 support to your Arduino. If not, that can be simply done by navigating into this expressive Arduino ESP32 repository in GitHub and get into this boardmanagers.md file and copy this release link. Again, I'll give the link down below in the description. So just copy this link, get into preferences, add your link over here, then get into board manager and search for ESP32 and just hit the install button. And after that, you need to install the required libraries for the OLED and the LoRa module. So if you have done that, just let's get into this manage libraries. And search for U8G2. So this library over here by Oliver will help us to communicate with the LCD module. Again, this supports whole lot of LCD, OLED and ALIC modules. So just close it. And for LoRa, we need to get into this, do this Arduino ELMIC repository by MathGJS. So just get into this and click on download chip. Now get into your Arduino, get into libraries, add zip file, select the downloaded zip file. And get into this over here, examples, and you can see ELMIC Arduino as well as the U8G2 library popping up. So just close this, minimize this, and let's open up the code that I have written. And over here I have combined the Arduino ELMIC library as well as the OLED display library and written this code that will simply send data that we are intended to. And if the button is pressed, the connected LED will flash for 2 times, and whenever the LoRa module receives data, it will flash for 3 times. So again, this is the code So let's quickly go through it. So over here at first you'll get all the include files and all. This is LMIC, then HAL, SPI for communication and all with the LoRa module. Then the UAT cross 8 leaf for the OLED display. After that we have declared some variables and with some hex values. We'll get into that if whenever you get into the TTN website. Then over here is the declarations and all. This my data holds whatever data we want to send to the like TTN cloud server. Again, this can be changed and made dynamic depending upon if you are like interested in connecting some sensors and all. So this just object for sensor and all. Then over here the important thing is to define the correct pins that is been used by the LoRa module out of the ESP32 module. So the module I'm using is the Haltech one, and this uses these pins. So make sure you check this out, otherwise it will not work. Then we have defined the like OLED module and all. Then I have defined a couple of pins to interface the IOs, that is the button and the LED. So it's on event, means whenever some LoRa event happens and all, this function is get called. So I have used only one, but there are so many other events that can be used depending upon the LoRa class you are using or the method of activation you are using. So again, over here I'm going to use ABP method, so I'm not used all other events. So this is simply like drawing some data like text on the display. Then over here, if data is received, it will print into the serial terminal. Again, as the TTN server limits the data download to 4 per day, I have not used the download link, and I'm just only sending the data. Again, if you want to like receive data out of it from the TTN cloud, you can do so. You just need to modify the code over here. Then we are having some delay and clearing up the disk. Getting into this data downlink, I'm just printing out into the terminal, but again you can do it to the display also if it is required, or you can control some like GPIOs and all if it is required in your application. But make sure not to exceed the 4 limit set by the TTN fair usage policy. Then after this, this is default case and all. Then I have written a function LED flash to flash the LED number of times you want. So that's it with that. Then after that, do send function is there, and it is just showing the button is pressed, because I'm only sending data whenever the particular button connected to the GPIO is pressed, otherwise it will not send data. But if you want to send data in a timely basis or so, we can do that by just like uncommenting this line over here. This is OS set time callback, but don't forget to mention TX intervals. So that will be the interval in milliseconds after which data will be sent periodically. So just uncomment it if you want it. Then over here, just printing out something like if it is already sending data, it will say I'm not sending the data again. It's busy and all. Then otherwise it will just print out that packet is queued and is going to be sent. Then in setup, I've just initialized the LCD module, set the font and set a dummy text on top of it. Then initialize the serial port. Then define the pins, that is the button and the LED. Then the LoRa installations. Then over here some key, we are just going to key. Then over here just keys are being copied to the memory and all. So I'll not get into that. That is pretty much there in the library itself. So the important thing over here is the channels that have been defined according to the TTN usage. But after that, I have just disabled like 3 channels, because in our country we are not going to use the 868 megahertz channels. We are just limited with 865 and 867 megahertz. So I have disabled these 3 channels. Those are using 868 megahertz. Then again, there are a couple of declaration with transmission power and the spreading factor. That after that, in the loop, we are having a OS run loop. This takes care of all the library related steps like cleaning up and the task and all of the things. Then we have written a simple detail push button thing. So So it is just going to read the GPIO. If it is, has been grounded, it is going to call the DoSend function. And I have added a delay to handle the debouncing situation. So let's just quickly compile it. And over here, to do that, we just need to select the module. And we are going to use the Haltech one. So it is over here. Yep, this Haltech Wi-Fi LoRa 32. So just select it. So guys, that's pretty much all about the code and what is happening over here. And before dumping the code to the controller, make sure to register the node of the device. And to do that, let's get into the Things network. And similarly, get into console like we did in while registering the gateway. So over here, get into application. You can add a new application. Let's say test application. Then you can have a description of it. Then choose the handler. So I'll go with the default one. Just click on. Okay, and this already exists. So just add some text to it. Yep, that is done. And under devices, you'll see 0 registered devices. So just click on register device. Then a device ID, let's say dummy node. It can have hyphen, it will only take underscore node. So I'll just make the device UI be given by the system or auto generated. Click on register. Now on the device, get into settings and make sure to select ABP because we are going to use the ABP mode. So just click on save. And over here we need to copy all these parameters to the Arduino sketch. So let's make it, first thing is the device address. Just copy it as show the data in hex format. And again, just copy this. That is the network session key. So just replace this with the network session key that we have copied. Yep. The next thing we need to copy is the app session key. Again, hit this button over here and copy in the hex format. Okay. Just make sure all the credentials are correct. Otherwise, you will not be getting the data in the cloud. So guys, now let's upload the code to the board. I'll just go ahead and select the code. It's okay. Now click on upload. And let's open up the console also so that you can see the debug messages. Now over here, as soon as the code runs, it will print out starting to the console. Now I'm just going to press the button attached to the module itself, and that prints out packet queued. And if the data has been transmitted, it will print out the event, that is EVTX complete. And this is actually sending data to the TTN console, as I said earlier. So over here on the TTN page, get into data, and you can see you'll find a data package over here. Let's select it and let's check it out in real time. Whenever I press the button, it prints out and it will find the data over here. So what it contains is the payload that we have sent, along with some other parameters like the frequency that is used, the time, modulation, data rate, the coding rate, and all the stuffs, including some gateways parameter. So over here you can see it has used the gateway and it has been detected by only one gateway. So if your packet is being detected by multiple gateways, you'll see all the gateways listed over here. So you'll find all gateway related stuff like timestamp and other things. As this particular gateway belongs to me only, so we can get into gateways, and over here I can check in traffic. So let's try it up, and once again I'll push the button. I can see in the gateway itself, you'll see the data appearing.
So if you don't have access to the particular gateway that has sent the data to the TTN console, you might not be able to see that, but as it is mine, I can log in and check it out. But over here, the data that is being sent is quite encrypted, which is like the gateway operators can't see the payload that you are sending to the TTN console. So again, if you have not checked my video around it, like how to make a simple gateway using like Raspberry Pi and RAC831 module, you can check it out. I've given the link down below in the description. So that's pretty much all about it, guys. As you can see, it is pretty much working, and that's all about it. I hope you have liked this video. If so, hit the thumbs up button, and if you have not subscribed yet, consider subscribing our channel. So see you next time with our next video. Till then, goodbye.